So here we are for our last teaching writing through technology webinar. Welcome everybody. And to get us started, how do you feel today on the Sherlock Holmes scale? You can type the number in the chat. How do you feel, Julia?
I think that today's our last teaching writing. I think I feel kind of like a six.
What about you, ladies? Sandrita, you're here. Good to see you. Indeed, indeed. But we'll have more webinars. So I think that I'm more like eight in a way. Good, good. So today we will review and revise the main writing subskills. Then we will explore Google Forms features and uses, and we will assess the use of Google Forms for writing tasks. Okay, it's time to take a look at the writing lesson. Then that will be about writing detective stories. I chose this one because I found that these type of stories is more engaging for my students. Yeah. So we will look at the writing lesson. Then we will do a Google Forms quiz. We will read a detective story in an interactive way on Google Forms, of course, and we will create a story ending in the same forms. Then, okay, as we always do, I will show you the context of this writing lesson. Yeah. So I used Google Slides to prepare this presentation. Let me share with you. Good. Here it is. Mm-hmm. Can you all see my screen? Great.
Fantastic. Yes.
So the first thing you can do with your students is to ask them which detective stories they are familiar with. I chose these three, for example, that I find that are well-known or important. And I prepared a quiz on GForms too that we will do now all together. And we will see, for example, what elements are essential to good detective stories, checks learners' background knowledge on these type of stories, and we'll have some extra questions here. Okay, so time to do the quiz then. You can show them at the beginning of a story, because as we always say, it's very important to expose them to a model. And then you can expose them to the following part of the story, but in a more interactive way. Okay, so we will do this together, as I said, doing a Google Form, on a Google Form. For this, you will have an introduction for the story, and then you'll have the possibility to choose how you want the story to go, and then to create your own ending for the story. So it's time to go to another Google Form for this. Let me share with you. So here it is. For this, you will have the introduction here. And if you choose any of this option, it will take you to a different storyline, yeah? And then it goes on, all right? For this, Julio will again paste the link on the chat for you to have this experience.
It's already there. You can go to and create your own adventure. This would be very similar to reading the Dungeon Dragon novels. I don't know if any of you got to read one of those.
Exactly. For the ones who have just joined, We are talking about detective stories today, and we are doing different activities on Google Forms, and you will find them on the chat, yeah? Yes, for this activity, you have 2 minutes, and for the last part, what you can do is just write one sentence to be able to send them to us. So yes, to do faster, let me share with you. Brilliant, let me share with you the answers. So 6 people managed to answer so far, this is brilliant. I can see that the first option was the first storyline was the preferred one, apparently. And
nobody followed mine.
You see?
Mine was the second, yeah. Oh, mine was not interesting. Mine was not interesting enough.
But it didn't get there, you see? We have some very funny, you know, very funny finals here. Okay, you can see, you can do this with your students and you can get them to read the stories, you know, and to tell the endings.
Okay, I got to see that too. At least 2 people got to talk about Ryan also. That's was kind of my ending. So you like my storyline too. That's very nice to see.
By the way, the Randall's version was written by Julio. That's what she's talking about.
So now that we got to see all your stories, let's start asking some questions about how all these turn out. How all these activities helped you, and how we managed to get you as our students to produce this part of the story. Now, what were the key elements in the detective story? Let's say if we could elicit that with your, when you were using the stories. A crime scene, very nice, Gabby. And by the way, Gabby, we're going to talk about how we managed to do those different options later.
Yes.
Later today.
After okay, the so discussion.
After this, we will go there. Exactly, a suspect, a crime scene, what else?
Remember the options in the first 2 form?
Clues, very nice. Detective, clues, murder, which is a crime. Exactly, and once we have all these clues and people and suspects, we should get to a yeah. A solution or a conclusion. Very nice, we'll both, yes. Exactly. Now, is there any specific vocabulary for this genre? Maybe you can give me some examples. Okay, some things that you adverbs and adjectives, very, very nice. Exactly, it's why are they this important? Of course, you can explain your students that, of course, authors these genres tend to describe very, very much the scenarios as they can discover clues and different things. And of course, precise language. I don't know if you are very familiar with this type of stories, but detective stories tend to have like very, very, very precise language that detectives can use.
Exactly, and now, crime vocabulary specifically as well, right?
Exactly, thank you, Mika. And now, what tenses are used in this type of genre? Okay, what tenses are typically used? Simple past, very nice. Only simple past. Present perfect, present simple, very nice. Exactly. And we call them narrative tenses, which in that includes exactly all of this. And what structure needs to be followed?
Is there any structure like introduction? Which sequence? What do you think?
Yes. Is there a sequence for this type of stories?
Mm-hmm.
You shouldn't start with a crime scene exactly. You should be chronological, unless you are Gabriel García Márquez. Or
yeah, it starts with a setting. Yeah. Exactly. We need to describe.
We need to usually we describe the scene, then we find the clues, exactly right in action.
Oh, that's perfect, Lucia.
Very specific. Okay, thank you, Lucia. now, before discussing this, Mika will explain you now how we can use or we can build all these things with using G forms.
Exactly. Thank you, Julio. We have some questions before delving into that. So, have you ever used Google Forms before? What kind of activities have you created? Can you think of any? Have you used any lessons?
Mm-hmm. Are Google Forms usually fun or interesting?
Okay, for tests, says Gabby. Yeah, exactly. So what I find specifically useful about Google Forms is that you can turn the information, I mean the responses, into useful data, into useful data that can be shared with students and that you can use, further in the course, and you can see where students are standing, right? So now it's time to create our own Google Forms. And if you want, you can do this with me as I do it. Otherwise you can do it afterwards. You can watch the recording and, and do it later. So first of all, we will go to a new tab and I've got the Google Apps here. I mean, you can open the Google Apps where you have it on your computer and go to Forms. Once you click on Forms, you go to this plus icon here and go to blank. Click there and you will open a new form automatically. You can click here and edit this and add your title, your description. What I do is write the tasks here, the assignments. So the instructions are very clear. Complete this, blah, blah, blah. And then I want this to be divided into sections. So if I want to do as I did in the choose your own adventure type, I can, have different storylines. So I will go to add section and I will have, say, 4 sections for this. So here we have the title and we can add a question or a title or description. So I want to talk about, say, summer versus winter, blah. And you can add a question with this plus icon. So I can ask, for example, what do you prefer? Okay, and option one is the cold weather. And the second is the hot weather. And this can be the setting of the story, for example. And I want this to be, to look appealing for my students. So I go to this icon and go to add image and then go to Google email search. And then I go to cold, for example. And I like this one, so I select this one. you know. Oh, there, geez, looks. So I want these to lead, if a student clicks on the first one, I want them to lead to this section. So let's do, I don't know, try to use a word here for this section that is really helpful. So it can be, for example, I don't know, cold beverages. I don't know, something that is related to this. So you come back to this one, and then, first of all, it needs to be required. And here, click on these three little dots, and it says, go to section based on answer. And this is a secret here. You click there, and you have continue to next section, and it will go to cold beverages. So, and then you build all these, you know, you do the same with this one. So for the part of hot weather, you will have to create another section, you know, warm food, for example. I don't know, I'm just making this up, you know, and then you have to go back and select this, you know, warm food. And make sure that this works, okay. Good. And then you can have several types of questions, you know. Here I want to add, again, a title. Okay, so if it goes to the wrong place, you can, you know, put it here. And describe this, and then add. I want it to be a checkbox. So here students can choose more than one option. You can add videos if you want, and so on and so forth. Well, let's suppose that now I finish the questions. I want to customize this. So I can go to Heather here and choose an image. You have plenty of options here. Here it is. No? Doesn't it look nicer? Oh, come on, you're supposed to say yes. Yeah. Okay, so now I want to see how my students will see this. So I go to preview. Ah, now I can see it, you know? And if I choose cold weather, pick, it'll take me to cold beverages, you know? As we did with our stories. And if you want to do, if you don't want to do this, choose your adventure type of form, you can go to quizzes and make this a quiz. So it will assign points to every questions, you know, as we did in the first form. Okay. Lovely. Yes. So we need to start running on for that. I will ask you, what tools did we see, if you remember? I'm going to share my screen for us to round up very quickly. So this one is for add-ons. I didn't mention, but this is like, if you want to add Unsplash, for pictures and so on. This was for add a question. So you can add several types of questions with this one. You can import a question with this one. You can recycle questions from other forms. You can add a title and a description to a section with this one, add image, add videos, and add sections, okay? Then with this icon, you can customize theme, add a header, a picture, and a background color as we did. With this one, you preview. With this one, you can turn the form into a quiz and, you know, a self-marking quiz. And with this one, you can get the sharing link for your students. So you click on send, and it will automatically appear the option for you to share a link, yes? How time consuming was it to create a detective story?
I think it depends on the source that you have, Gabby. It depends. For example, if you have a ready-made story, it will take you only the time to create the several branches that you want. And it will depend on how fast you could come up with the ideas. But it took us to create the whole thing. It took us like 30 to 40 minutes.
Yeah, exactly. I think what's key is to have one storyline already ready, and then you do it the alternative one or the alternative ones if you want to make more. That'll go faster in a way. Yes. Exactly. Yes. Different
it
levels.
Would change drastically according to the level. Yes. Mm-hmm. And, well, just to round up, I think it was nice to see how, I mean, we can do all these different things from Google with Google Forms. I know that most of us see Google Forms just to complete surveys online or something like that. But well, yes, I think that this is something that that you can add now to your lessons. I don't know. So maybe if we can, we have a list of benefits here, Micaela.
Yes. And one of them is, let me share my screen. One of them is that it helps you organize the lesson in a clear sequence.
Yeah. Yes. As you know, in at least my experience, I've seen teachers that they need to follow the lesson plan just step by step, okay? And it sometimes helps you, I mean, to have this organization very clear. And well, I think that, well, Google Forms helps you to do that. And also it's a great way to collect your students' production in an online lesson, which is something that can be very difficult when you are teaching online and where you need to check the learner's production. If you have a whole group, okay, it may be easy with one because you can share a Google Doc or something, but I think this is a very, very nice and, let's say, effective way to collect all that info. Also, it's very, very user-friendly. You can see that, I mean, many of you already know it, Google Forms, but just learning all these things that we just practiced today will totally change how the perception that we have about Google Forms. And it's very user-friendly and of easy access, not only for us and for our students, because it's free. So that's always a plus. And also it's a means to document the students' production for future reference. So you can see the students' evolution. Okay, yeah, when you have these Excel form that I don't remember when Micaela shared it. And also it is very simple, but it is also a very appealing tool. Okay, and it also has like this plus that it gives students the sense of having a workbook. And this is something that some students miss, because as we said at the beginning, for some teachers need the plan, whereas some students need the workbook. And I think that, and yes, this gives learners this help.
Definitely.
It's a visible record, yes. Okay, well, with this, we have reached the end of our first series in teaching online. I want to thank you for being here. And I don't know if you have any questions so far.
If you have any questions, you can complete the form that I will leave in the chat. Okay, yes. And you can leave us feedback as well.
Yes, okay. It was here.
It was fantastic to see you all here, and yeah, we will announce webinar series on different sub skills soon. Okay, thank you so much for being here. Bye bye, and have a nice rest of the day. Fantastic. Bye bye.
Bye.
Thank you guys. Bye bye.
Bye.